Hello, so in today's video, I'll be making a pen out of all these things. So what I have here is I have a pen kit, and I'm going to borrow some tools to grab this piece of olive wood to turn it in a lathe and make a pen out of this. I haven't done this before. I worked with some wood before, but not to this extent, so it should be kind of fun. So I'm going to go ahead and set everything up and start recording the video. So here we go. I first started by trimming the wood blank into two smaller pieces closer to the size of the metal tubes that are the inside of the pen, and I'm drilling a hole through the center so I'm able to fit the pen insides into the wood planks. So I do both pieces, and now I'm ready to move on into gluing the metal cylinders inside the wood blanks. So I do this by using CA glue, and I coat the metal cylinder all the way throughout. It's very important that we don't leave any areas uncovered with glue, because we want to make sure that it's very stable inside. And now I use this wooden fence I've created to push one end in so it's flush to one of the sides of the wood plank, and I do it to both pieces. Now I go in and I trim the other side down to the metal tube. That guarantees that when we are working with the pen and putting it together, it's all going to work perfect. Now going in, I have both of the pieces on a metal tube with a spacer in between, and the spacers are the same thickness of what the pen will be. I'm using a squared tool to start carving away the excess. As you saw before, I'm using a square piece of wood, and I have to obviously take that down to more of a cylinder shape before I'm able to start carving in the shape of a pen. This way I can get rid of most of the excess with this tool, because it's not a precise carving tool. Once it starts feeling like it's a little bit more cylinder shape, I use the tool on the top to see how smooth it is, and now I'm using my finger to get the same feeling. Now I'm able to go in and start working on the pen shape. I'm a little bit under the weather, so that's why probably why my voice sounds different on the voiceover versus the regular video. So that's just a little disclaimer. Now I'm going in and I notice there's a lot of excess wood on there. It will be a very thick pen that's going to look a little awkward with very small pen nibs and parts, so I have to get rid of a lot of the wood. Which is fine, I wanted for it to feel more comfortable and slimmer on the user's hand, but yeah, I'm gonna keep that in mind, how much wood you have on the lathe and how much you need to remove. Now I switch tools. Now I'm using a rounder bit. This is going to help with creating more rounded off shapes, because the square one will just give you very straight lines. This I'm using to give it more of a shape, especially on the holding part. If you're looking at the camera right now, the part I'm working on, the part farthest away from the camera, is going to be the top of the pen, and the part closest to us is going to be the handle part where we hold the pen to write. So I want to get it as smooth as possible to the paint part, so I'm trying to get it so that the edges of both pieces are almost flush to the metal piece that's holding it in the middle. I do recommend stopping the lathe every once in a while just to get a better look of what the pen is looking like. Make sure we don't have any cracks or we don't have any issues to address while we're working on it. Since the wood's spinning so fast, it's hard to tell what's actually going on other than just the general shape. now I'm kind of happy with how it's going. I'm taking my time now just to try to get the wood as smooth as possible and get rid of any tool marks, which we can also do with sanding, which is going to be the next step. So here is the pen so far. I'm checking the shape, I'm pretty happy with it, and now I'm taking a look at it to see what I have to address in the sanding process. So now I'm using some rougher sandpaper just to get a better shape and get rid of any tool marks. There are always going to be tool marks, that's just going to be unavoidable. So I'm trying to just get everything smoothed down, the edges, all the parts that are made in the metal pan parts are going to need some work to get them so they match perfectly. And now it's time to move on to the next step. Now for the finish, I'm using the same CA glue that I utilized to glue in the metal tubes in the center of the wood, and I'm using a paper towel folded over. You don't want to just use it as a single sheet of paper towel because it will get glued to your fingers. I've done that before, and I'm just coating it all the way throughout the pan, making sure that I twist the lace so that I get all areas covered. And then after you get the wood on there, you want to turn the lathe back on so that the spinning of the lathe dries off the pen. After the glue is dry, we start using the sandpaper pads that I got, going from the roughest sandpaper to the smoothest. This is going to help create a nice shiny finish to the pen and also protects the wood. I did this step about 6 times or so. You can do it as many times as you want. The more you do it, the better the finish is going to be. But of course, at one point, it's diminishing returns, so you don't have to do it all the time. So here it is. You can see how much more the wood grain pops now that it has a finish. You can see the shine on the pen, and it feels very smooth to the touch. So it's going to be a nice pen to use. Now we have the pen parts right here, and it's time to put the pen pieces together. So I made sure that I started with the tip, and I had a little bit of a hard time getting the tip in there, so I used a clamp to put some pressure for the tip to go in. And after that, we put in what is called the transmission, which is a turning part of the pen. We put the rest of the pieces together, and we have a finished pen. So here's the finished product. I'm pretty proud with the way that it came out. Again, the wood I utilized was olive wood, and I went with black pen pieces because I felt that since it's a lighter wood with a contrasting pen part, it's going to make the grain stand out even more. Thank you for watching my video. Hope you enjoy. Thanks. Thanks for watching my video. Make sure to like it, leave a comment below, and for more art related videos, go to my channel and subscribe.